In this video, we will give you a quick overview on our CANetNet NT, a flexible and reliable and easy accessible product for CAN and CANFD networks with lots of interesting functions, applicable as a bridge, gateway and PC interface, depending on your use case. From coupling of CAN and CANFD systems to exchanging of CAN messages via Ethernet or long distances, everything is possible. Hey, my name is Tobi and in this video I'm going to cover the CANetNet NT, a powerful and versatile bridge, gateway and PC interface solution for CAN and CANFD networks. In general, the CANetNet NT series is a 3-in-1 multifunctional talent for the CAN world. They can act as a gateway between CAN and Ethernet systems, providing easy, flexible access to up to 4 independent CAN systems via LAN or over the internet. As a CAN Ethernet CAN bridge, the CANetNet NT allows the exchange of CAN messages between CAN systems over long distances via TCP/IP using existing Ethernet infrastructures. The CANetNet NT 200 and 420 also allow easy coupling of CAN and CANFD systems. The segmentation of CAN systems also increases the reliability and failure safety of the entire system. Messages can be processed, filtered and mapped in the gateway. In addition, a wide variety of actions can be performed automatically in response to received messages and device or CAN bus statuses. Whether device status or CAN CANFD data, the MQTT protocol implemented in CANetNet NT enables the information to be transmitted to the cloud. But now I will give you an overview of the different CANetNet NT variants and I will reveal the cool and useful functions that live under the hood. So let's get started. HMS offers 3 versions of the device, the CANetNet NT100 with 1 CAN channel and sub-D9 plug, the CANetNet NT200 with 2 CAN channels and the CANetNet NT420 with 2 additional CANFD channels, which can also be switched to CAN, so you can have in total 4 CAN channels if needed. All 3 versions offer 3 operation modes. They can be used as PC interface to connect your PC application with a CAN or CANFD networks. For this application, powerful programming APIs for Windows and Linux are included. You can use them as a CAN Ethernet gateway, providing an open ASCII protocol via Ethernet, which enables interactions with non-Windows and non-Linux systems. Finally, they can be used as a CAN Ethernet CAN bridge, enabling intelligent interconnection of CAN and CANFD networks. Also, long distances via Ethernet. All variants have a galvanic isolation to decouple and protect devices and to make communication more reliable. We made a video about galvanic isolation, it's linked in the description below. Failures and expensive repairs caused by overvoltage can thus be avoided, and the more stable communication reduces cost-intensive disruptions in operation. If you use the CANetNet NT within your CAN or CANFD systems as a bridge, a wide range of functions is provided, enabling an intelligent uncoupling of signals. You can connect CAN networks with different communication standards, protocols or baud rates. You can filter messages or map content from one message frame to another, ideal for CAN to CANFD conversion. And you can modify message content. All this can be configured very easily using the Ixxat CAN Gateway Configurator, a Windows-based tool which helps even inexperienced users to get the system up and running quickly and easily. And the tool offers even more. With action rules, you can select events and actions using simple drop-down lists. So for example, the CANetNet NT can react to device status or in incoming messages by sending out alarms or CAN messages. And this is where MQTT comes into play. The CANetNet NT can be connected to an MQTT broker via Ethernet and can send and receive messages. So simple remote monitoring and alarming is always on board. When we speak about Ethernet connections, configurable security levels for device access are a must and are, of course, included. Now, I've told you a lot about our communication talents. So, let's unpack one. In the box, you find, of course, the device and also a hardware user manual. And a USB cable is in the box too, but configuration can also be made by using an Ethernet connection. For the PC interface operation, you will need the VCI driver for Windows, available on our website. We've made a video about it. Please always check our webpage for the latest driver and software versions. You will find the links below in the description. For now, that's all. But if you would like to learn more about the device configuration, then watch our CAN Gateway Configurator video. In this video, I show you how the CANet NT is configured and we give a more detailed overview about the wide range of functions. I will put the link in the description below as well. So thanks for watching, and if you liked the video, please leave us a like. If you have any questions, leave us a comment and follow our channel. See you next time. Bye bye.